Hello and welcome students. In this module, we will learn more about the climate of India and we'll proceed with the cycle of seasons. We have already learned about the cold weather season and the hot weather season. Now, we'll learn about the rainy season in India. So, the rainy season in India is also known as the season of southwest monsoon. So students, let's start. This season starts with the onset of southwest monsoon and lasts until September. So this season starts as the hot weather season gets over and a low pressure develops over the northwestern part of India, and therefore the southeast trade winds are attracted towards the Indian subcontinent. And here starts the rainy season or the southwest monsoon season. So students, like we have learnt about the other seasons, we will take up the temperature condition, pressure, the winds, and we'll also learn about the precipitation, that is rainfall. So in this way we'll learn about the season in detail. So let's start with the temperature condition. So here we'll see what is the temperature condition during the rainy season. So the monsoon rainfall, as soon as the rainfall starts, the temperature begins to fall. This means the rainfall starts and there is some modification in the weather condition. The temperature drops to a certain extent because of the rainfall. The northwestern parts and the desert region of Rajasthan hills have temperature about 40 degrees Celsius. So it's still in the temperature condition in the northwestern part and in Rajasthan, it still remains 40 degrees Celsius. So this is the temperature condition of the during the rainy season. Now we'll see the pressure condition and what is the nature of the winds. So here the northwestern part still has high temperature and low pressure. So let's see in the map. Northwestern portion, it is still having high temperature, and because of this high temperature, low pressure is maintained. This means the strong low pressure can pull the southeast trade wind. Children, the southeast trade winds I have marked here. When it crosses the equator, due to the Coriolis effect, it turns towards its right, deflect towards its right in the northern hemisphere and start blowing from southwest direction. I have already told this, we have discussed in the previous module. So in the northwestern part prevails high temperature and low pressure, which attracts the wind from sea to land. In early June, in the beginning of June, low pressure conditions are very strong enough to attract the trade winds of the southern hemisphere. So from the southern hemisphere, the southeast trade winds are attracted, and they, when they cross the equator, they get deflected towards their right according to the Ferrell's law due to the Coriolis effect, and they enter from ocean to land. They move towards the land. Now students, these southeast trade winds are of oceanic origin because they are moving from sea to land. So they are of oceanic origin. This means this kind of wind will have a lot of moisture and will be capable of causing very heavy rainfall. So as these winds, they cross the equator, they blow as southwest monsoon. So children, these winds, as I told, they get deflected as they cross the equator, and they start blowing as southwest monsoon. Now they get deflected towards their right after crossing the equator due to the Coriolis effect. So students, we have already understood this. Let's proceed. Blowing over the Indian Ocean, they get bifurcated into two branches due to the tapering shape of the subcontinent. Now students, as they are about to enter the subcontinent, they get divided into two branches because of the tapering shape of the continent. One branch moved towards Bay of Bengal and the another one moves towards the Arabian Sea. So they get bifurcated or divided into two branches. Now what happens? Let's see. From here, when they get divided into two branches. First one is the Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon. So this is the southwest monsoon because it is blowing from southwestern direction, and one first branch enters Arabian Sea, takes moisture from the Arabian Sea, and the next branch is the Bay of Bengal branch. This branch takes moisture from the Bay of Bengal. So like this, the southwest monsoon gets divided into two branches. Now children, we'll see how these two branches, they move all over the ocean, enters the land, and they further get divided into branches, and they cause rainfall almost all over the country. So let's see what happens in the peninsular part. In the peninsular India, they flow in a southwesterly direction. Children, we can see very clearly in the map given that all over the southern peninsula, as they enter, they blow in a westerly, southwesterly direction. So they are blowing in a southwesterly direction. So this is about peninsular India, in the southern part of India. What happens when they reach the northern part? So here, their direction changes. So just see carefully. Their direction changes in the Indo-Gangetic plain, where they move from east to west. Why? Due to the relief features and the low pressure in the northwestern part of India. So now let's understand. They entered like this from southwest, but as they reached here, they came across the Himalayas. So they had to change their direction and they started moving from east to west. So they started moving from east to west. So I hope children, this is clear. So the reasons, there are two reasons. First, the presence of the Himalayas, and the second, there is a low pressure. So low pressure will attract the winds. So due to the low pressure in the northwestern part, the winds are attracted from east to west. And secondly, the Himalayas, due to the Himalayas, when they reach here, they strike the Arakan Yoma. This is in Myanmar. This is actually extension of Himalayas in Myanmar. So when they strike, they get deflected. The Arakan Yoma makes the wind deflect towards the Indian subcontinent. So the wind gets deflected and they start flowing from east to west. So students, this is how in the southern part of India, they were blowing in southwesterly direction, southwest, from southwest. But as they reach the north, they get deflected and they start moving from east to west. So students, this is how they change their direction. Now next we'll learn about the rainfall, the precipitation during the rainy season. This is the most important part. Let's see. So 3/4 of the total rainfall in India, 3/4 of the total annual rainfall of India is received during this season. So this is the major season where most of the rainfall, about 3/4 rainfall, is received all over the country. The progress of monsoon is in two branches, and the first monsoon rain is experienced in Kerala coast. All right, so the first monsoon strikes the Kerala coast, and the tentative date for the arrival of monsoon is 1st of June. So the Kerala coast experienced the first shower of monsoon on 1st of June. This is a tentative date. It might vary a few days. So they move in two branches, Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal. We have already learnt about this. Let's see more. Arabian Sea branch strike the Kerala coast on 1st June. So the 1st June is the date for arrival of monsoon, and the windward side of the Sahyadris received very heavy rainfall. So children, if you remember when we learnt about the physical features, Sahyadri is another name for Western Ghats. You can see the series of hills, and here mentioned Western Ghats. So Western Ghats or Sahyadris, they pose a rain shadow effect. They become a rain shadow barrier. So they become a barrier, and the winds, the Arabian Sea branch, when it is about to enter the continent, subcontinent of India, it strikes the Western Ghats and heavy downpours. The windward side, the western side of the Western Ghats, receive very good amount of rainfall due to the rain shadow effect. So students, this is the first shower of monsoon received in India. 1st of June is the date when Kerala coast experiences rainfall, and this monsoon wind, it strikes the Sahyadri, and also very heavy rainfall occur on the western side of the Western Ghats or Sahyadris. Now the rain wind proceed, the monsoon winds proceed. It crosses the Western Ghats, overruns the Deccan Plateau and Madhya Pradesh, causing fair amount of rainfall. Now children, here we'll see maximum rainfall occurred on the western side of Western Ghats. Now this wind will cross over Deccan Plateau and will reach Madhya Pradesh. So Deccan Plateau and Madhya Pradesh will not receive heavy amount of rainfall, because most of the rainfall occurred on the western side and less moisture is left. So when the wind proceeds to the interior, less moisture is left, resulting in less rainfall. The rainfall will reduce as the wind will proceed interior of the subcontinent. So then they reach the Ganga Plain. After the wind crosses Deccan Plateau and Madhya Pradesh, it will reach the Ganga Plain. It will reach the Ganga Plain, and here it will merge with the Bay of Bengal branch. Children, you can see from Bay of Bengal a branch is coming and entering. So from with this branch, Arabian Sea branch will merge. Both the branches will merge here in the Ganga Plain. This is the plain of Ganga. Here both the branches will meet. Now next, what happens? Another branch, there is one branch of Arabian Sea proceeded, it just caused rainfall on the Western Ghat, and then it moved over Deccan Plateau, Madhya Pradesh, and finally merged with the Bay of Bengal branch in the Ganga Plains. Now there is another branch of Arabian Sea that strikes, you can see children, I'll show the movement of the wind. It will strike Saurashtra Peninsula and Kutch. So students, I'll show you a map. Look here. This is Gujarat, and this portion is Saurashtra, and this is the Kutch area, the Gulf of Kutch, the Kutch area. So I hope you have understood this. So this region is Saurashtra and Kutch region. I am marking it here. In this region, another branch of Arabian Sea strikes, and then it passes over Western Rajasthan. It moves over Western Rajasthan and along the Aravallis. Children, you can see, I'll just zoom in so that you can see. This is the Aravalli. So it crosses Aravalli. It almost runs parallel to the Aravallis. And as it is moving parallel to the Aravallis, Aravalli is not posing any barrier, therefore there is no rain shadow effect and there is no rainfall. So the rainfall is very, very scanty because Aravalli never poses a barrier and there is no rain shadow effect. So this is a very big reason of less rainfall in this area, because Aravalli lies parallel to the direction of the monsoon winds, the Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon. So students, I hope you have understood why Rajasthan and Thar desert area, they receive very less rainfall. So this is clear. Let's proceed. We have seen Saurashtra and Kutch area. Now in Punjab and Haryana, this branch join the Bay of Bengal branch. So The first branch of Arabian Sea, southwest branch of Arabian Sea, it starts from here, Deccan, MP, Madhya Pradesh, and then merges with the Bay of Bengal branch. The second branch of Arabian Sea, it starts from here, hits Saurashtra, Kutch, passes over Rajasthan along the Ravlis, and then here in Punjab and Haryana, they meet the Bay of Bengal branch. So this is first branch of Arabian Sea monsoon. This is the second branch, and both of them meet the Bay of Bengal branch in Punjab and Haryana. We also call this Punjab Plain. So this is all about the movement of the Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon. So the two branches, now these two branches, the Bay of Bengal branch and the Arabian Sea branch, when they meet, when these branches they meet, they become very strong. And when they become strong, they cause good amount of rainfall in the western Himalayas. So they got a pretty good amount of rainfall occurs because these branches meet and their moisture together becomes stronger, and they cause good amount of rainfall in the western Himalayas. Now students, we have learnt about the Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon. Let's learn about the Bay of Bengal branch, that how it proceeds and causes rainfall. Before that, there is a very important term we need to know, that is monsoon burst. So what do you mean by this? You will come across this word. This simply means the sudden rainfall during monsoon is termed as monsoon burst. So the monsoon winds blow at a speed of more than 30 kilometers per hour, and the sudden onset of moisture laden winds is associated with violent thunder, lightning, and very heavy downpours. So these are the characteristics which is like visible during the monsoon onset of monsoon, when the monsoon arrives. So this is known as monsoon burst. It's a sudden change of conditions from very hot weather season to the rainy season. So students, we have already learnt about the nature of the Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon. Now we learn about the Bay of Bengal branch of southwest monsoon. Let's see how it proceeds and brings rainfall. So this branch is directed towards the coast of Myanmar and part of southeast Bangladesh. Let's see. So it blows, this wind blows all over the Bay of Bengal, and it proceeds towards Myanmar. So I'll mark Bangladesh and Myanmar region. Alright. So this is Myanmar region. This is Bangladesh. So here it reaches here. Now what happens? Arakan Yoma range. You can see here Arakan Yoma. Children, this is Arakan Yoma is extension of Himalayas in Myanmar. So Himalayas, you know, is a fold mountain. So it extends from the northern part of India to northeast, and then also it gets diverted towards Myanmar, and there it is known as Arakan Yoma. So the Arakan Yoma range along the coast of Myanmar is good enough to deflect the wind. Students, we have discussed earlier also this, when the Bay of Bengal branch strikes, it gets deflected towards the subcontinent. You can see the arrows. It gets deflected and enters the Ganga Plain and reach the Punjab Plain here. So this is the first branch. Let's read. It deflects this wind, enabling it to enter the subcontinent. So this wind starts from here and strikes the Arakan Yoma and then get deflected towards the subcontinent, enters India and reaches the Punjab Plain. So this is the about the first branch. So the monsoon enters Bengal, Bangladesh from south and southeast. So the monsoon wind enters first in India, enters Bangladesh, and then in Bengal, and then proceeds further. This branch then splits into two due to the presence of Himalaya and due to the presence of low pressure in the northwestern part of India. So children, now also the low pressure is very strong in the western part. That's why it is pulling all the wind from sea to land. And therefore the monsoon is very strong. So what happens? As the monsoon wind strike the Bay of Bengal branch, strike the Arakan Yoma, it gets deflected. Here it splits into two branches. One branch move over along the Himalayas and reaches the Ganga plain. So children, this map will explain you. The first branch entered the Punjab plain. I will just magnify this. You can see this is the Punjab plain. So this branch has started from here and reached Punjab plain. This is the first branch of Bay of Bengal, branch of southwest monsoon. And the second branch, it gets deflected towards the Assam valley, that is the Brahmaputra plains. Let's see. The wind, this wind, the branch which gets enters the Punjab plain from east to west, as it proceeds the moisture becomes less, means the wind gets drier as it proceeds westward away from the sea. So as this wind strikes the Arakan Yoma and then move inside India, enter the subcontinent and proceed towards Punjab plain, the wind becomes drier and drier because as it proceeds the moisture becomes less. So the rainfall, if we see the graph of the rainfall, the graph also lowers, the rainfall decreases from east to west. So I hope the first branch of Bay of Bengal is clear. Let's proceed to the another branch. The other branch, I told you, will move up to Brahmaputra Valley in the north and northeast, causing very heavy rainfall. So children, one branch moved towards this side. Another branch from here will move towards the Brahmaputra Valley in Assam. Children, here you can see the Garo Khasi Jayantia Hills. Children, these hills are very important because they are aligned in such a way that when the monsoon winds enter this valley, it gets trapped because it has to rise very high to cross these hills, and when it rises very high, it absorbs such a lot of moisture that this place becomes the rainiest place in the world. I'll show you. This is Meghalaya, state of northeast India, and here you can see the Garo, Khasi and Jayantia hills. So these are the hills and their alignment is such that they form a funnel shape, and the wind, the Bay of Bengal branch of southwest monsoon, it gets trapped, and when water evaporates and it tries to rise, it has to rise very high, and therefore it absorbs such a lot of moisture that it causes very, very heavy rainfall. Let's see more. So this is the map. See, Mausin Ram, located on the Khasi Hills, received the highest average annual rainfall in India. Children, the rainfall is very, very heavy. 1250 centimeters of rainfall, annual rainfall, is highest in the world. Cherrapunji, located 16 kilometers away. We can see here, Cherrapunji. This is merely 16 kilometers east of Mausin Ram. It used to receive the maximum highest annual rainfall earlier, but now since many years, Mausin Ram, located on the Khasi Hills, this place received the heaviest rainfall in the world. Now children, this is all about the rainy season. So related to this rainy season, there are few questions which comes to our mind. So the first question is, why Thar is a desert? So we have already discussed, but let's see in detail. Aravalli range, if I magnify this, you will see the Aravalli range. This lies parallel to the direction of southwest monsoon, Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon. So this is one of the biggest reason that the rainfall is less in this area. So it doesn't offer any obstacle. Aravallis is parallel, lies parallel to the South Arabian Sea branch of southwest monsoon. So it doesn't pose any obstacle. So no rain shadow effect, no rainfall, or we can say very, very scanty rainfall. The moisture-laden winds passing over Rajasthan do not saturate, as the heat of the desert region is so much that its capacity to hold moisture increases. Because of very high heat, the air, it goes on expanding, and the moisture is not sufficient to condense and to form clouds. And that's why the intense heat of the desert region, due to the sandy soil and less vegetation. Moreover, Aravalli is lying parallel to the monsoon winds. These two reasons are more than enough for Thar to be a desert. These are the reasons, children, for why the Thar is a desert. One more question here: why Mausam Ram is the wettest place on the earth? So just now we have discussed. Just recapitulate once more: the alignment of the northeastern hills, Garo, Khasi, Jayantia, Lusai, Mizo. There are several hills, children. So these are the major ones, and they are such that they form a funnel shape and trap the monsoon wind. When these winds take a sudden rise, they cause very heavy rainfall. So children, this is Mausam Ram in the map in Meghalaya. So I have again put this map so that it becomes clear to you. We can see the hills. So students, that's all about the rainy season in India. I hope you understood. Thank you very much.